Hey guys, in this video I want to go over a topic that I have covered before, but it's worth rehashing every once in a while. So in this video I'm going to go over ICT basics, ICT draw on liquidity, what is the draw on liquidity, and what does it mean for price. So the draw on liquidity, simply put, is an inefficiency or liquidity above or below current market price. There are many draws on liquidity that are constantly acting on the price, but in terms of what is the draw, it should be a higher time frame draw, preferably 30 minutes or above. So let's take some examples and I'll show you what I mean. ICT has a number of, there are two concepts, right? Number one, you need to know where the market is currently trading. So when I say the first part of the puzzle is, what is current market price? Well, it's where price is currently trading. That's current market price. Okay? So right now it's 894 three quarters. That is current market price. There are two types of draws on liquidity, inefficiency and liquidity. Liquidity is very simply an old high or an old low. So I have two horizontal line drawings here on my trading view. One of them is buy side liquidity and one of them is sell side liquidity. Price is always going to be drawn to liquidity. It's always going to be worthwhile to notice where old highs and old lows are, because below there, there's going to be stops, and the market is always going to be drawn towards liquidity. The other draw on price is an inefficiency. Now, we have a good example here of what's called an ICT new day opening gap, which is currently sitting above current market price. There is a 1 hour resettlement period between 1700 and 1800 New York local time in which the futures market does not trade on a daily basis. If there is a gap between these two prices, it is referred to as a new day opening gap. And it is going to be a draw on liquidity if it's sitting above market price or if it's sitting below market price. Now, just because it's a draw on liquidity does not mean that it's going to act on the price very strongly or right away, or that there's not going to be a difficult time getting there. Okay, but it is something to be aware of. It's tugging on price. It's like a tugboat. It's a magnetic attraction, but it doesn't mean that the price is going to just buzz in a straight line to it. That would be what's called a low resistance liquidity run, and as you can tell, we have been drawing up to the new day opening gap here in overnight trading, but it's been a high resistance liquidity run with lots of retracement and lots of difficulty. So the draw on liquidity is quite simply an inefficiency on a higher time frame or liquidity on a higher time frame that is sitting above or below current market price. There are multiple draws on liquidity acting on price at all times. Some are going to be stronger than others. In most instances, you want to focus on inefficiency. So let's take an example of something that happened in the past. All right, so here we had buy side liquidity. Okay, so I'll hide that for a second. Here we had buy side liquidity. Now let's imagine that the market is sitting here, and you see that the market, this is in the overnight session, anywhere in here you can see that the market is not wanting to trade lower, right? You can see that the market, look at where all the candles are closing. You know that the market is probably going to draw to someplace higher. Now, we did have a sell side imbalance, buy side inefficiency, which was the first draw on the market price to go higher. But if the market were to get through this SIBI, what would be the next draw? Well, it was all the way back up here at that buy side liquidity. Now, eventually, you can see that the market did draw up and deliver that buy side liquidity. But notice that it took quite a bit of work and difficulty for price to get there. That is what's called a high resistance run on liquidity. It's where the draw on liquidity is there. You should know what it is. It's an inefficiency or liquidity above or below current market price on a higher time frame. But how the price is going to deliver that is more difficult to say. So in this example, you could tell that the price, when it wasn't going any lower here, you should immediately know, all right, well, it's going to draw to something higher. First, we have an inefficiency here, a SIBI here, and second, we have the buy side liquidity. Both of those targets were delivered, but it took quite a bit of resistance, and that's called a high resistance liquidity run, which is why, as a scalper, even though You know what the draw on liquidity might be. You don't exactly know how price is going to get there. So that's why you need to employ your money management, risk management, break-even stops, etc., etc. So anyways, guys, ICT Basics 101. What is the draw on liquidity? It is either A, an inefficiency above or below current market price, such as a new day opening gap, new week opening gap, sell-side imbalance, buy-side inefficiency, or buy-side imbalance, sell-side inefficiency. Both of those are fair value gaps. So it's either an inefficiency above or below current market price, or it is an old high or low, otherwise known as buy-side liquidity or sell-side liquidity, on a higher time frame, preferably 30 minutes and above. That is ICT Basics 101. What is the draw on liquidity? And by the way, just like I said before, just because you know what the draw on liquidity is, or what a draw on liquidity is, it doesn't mean that you know if price is going to get there in a straight line in an easy, low resistance way, or if it's going to chop and it's going to be a high resistance liquidity run. You really don't know. You can take guesses, but you really, at the end of the day, you don't know. This is why you have to employ money management, things like that. So one more time, what is the draw on liquidity? An inefficiency above or below current market price, or liquidity, buy-side liquidity or sell-side liquidity above or below current market price. Bye-bye.